Yo guys, what's up? Previously, we rounded up the Battle of France, and to the surprise of Nazi High Command, Hitler already revealed his next plan, the Soviet campaign. He had no desire to attack Great Britain, but wanted to exterminate every single Soviet, to clear out their country, to double Germany's Lebensraum for the thousand-year Reich. But his plan was delayed at the start of July 1940 because Churchill pulled Hitler's Luftwaffe into a direct confrontation with the Royal Air Force and the Royal Navy. If an invasion could be made until London to install a pacifist as Prime Minister, the Soviet campaign was not even required, seeing that Great Britain was an archenemy of the Soviet Union. It wasn't the first time that peace was seen as a positive thing by both sides. Russia had been dragged into World War I by Tsar Nicholas II, who suffered numerous defeats after opening up an East Front to take pressure off his ally, France. By 1916, the Treaty of Munich was signed for a repartition of territory, but soldiers and civilians felt angry and betrayed. In early 1917, with the Tsar far away from the city of Petrograd, now known as St. Petersburg, mass demonstrations in Petrograd and other cities and armed clashes with police and gendarmes broke loose starting March 8th. The Russians consider February 23rd to be the start date because of the difference between the Julian and Gregorian calendar, better known as Old Style and New Style. 4 days later, mutinous Russian army forces sided with the revolutionaries. The officials were not able to keep control over the crowd, and Tsar Nicholas II hurried back to North Russia with his train, but was continuously delayed and rerouted until the revolution had been completed. A government would replace the Tsar to give more power and rights to all Russian people. Nicholas II accepted and left Petrograd with his family, making it possible for Vladimir Lenin to leave his exile in Switzerland and to return home to shape the new ruling system. With the help of Leon Trotsky, the leader of the Bolsheviks, who were experienced war veterans, Lenin also accomplished the October Revolution, and an armistice with Germany was agreed in December 1917. Lenin and Trotsky agreed that no Russian would ever fight for imperialism ever again, only for the defense of the motherland. 5 years later, on December 30th of 1922, the Soviet Union replaced the Russian Empire, and Joseph Stalin became the first National Secretary until 1952. But Stalin and Trotsky had a troubled relationship, and to make it even worse, in 1924, Lenin passed away, with the city of Petrograd renamed to Leningrad as tribute. Stalin rose to ultimate power in the mid-20s, and by the late 30s he even performed the Great Purge, leading up to 600,000 deaths. He was also known for large-scale famines such as Ukraine in 1933, leading up to a death toll between 3 and 7 million. Just before the Poland campaign, Stalin and Hitler agreed to a non-aggression pact, which caused criticism from Leon Trotsky. After the Poland campaign was over, Stalin also embarked on an imperialistic journey in the Baltic region, but after a three-month winter war in Finland, he only managed to get an armistice out of it by March 1940. That would be respected until September 1941. After Finland, Lithuania became target number one and was annexed by June 15. Also, Latvia and Estonia were annexed in August. Both of their presidents were imprisoned in Siberia and died later. On August 21st, Stalin ordered the assassination of Leon Trotsky and his family, who had been living in exile in Coyoacan in Mexico. With Hitler fighting a war with archenemy Churchill, Stalin had no idea about the Soviet campaign and focused on illegal means to install Soviet puppet governments in the new Baltic regions by adapting the constitutions and falsifying elections. The enemies of the state would be deported, leading up to thousands of arrests and citizens living in fear. If a Nazi hand was necessary to get rid of the Soviets, the Baltic people would have no shame in accepting it. Also, Finland was in the same situation and was highly uncertain that the armistice with Stalin would continue to be respected. With Norway and the Baltic Sea belonging to Hitler, a German hand against Stalin would be greatly appreciated. It wasn't until April 1941 and the German war in Yugoslavia and Greece that Hitler's intentions became clear. By summer 1941, the Baltic regions would revert to Germany and Stalin would continue to struggle with the troops in this part of Northern Europe until the end of the war. The Soviet Union was seen as a nation of potato farmers, also by USA, but had the infamous T-34 tank at its disposal, as big as the Panzer IV, with better armor and more agile on unstable terrain than the Panzer. When Heinrich Himmler informed his high SS command about the Soviet campaign, he estimated that 30 million Soviets were going to die in this operation. Bevacizumab had been banned for public use because of all the bad side effects and severe addiction, but more and more medheads enlisted for the Wehrmacht because military purposes were still supplied with bevacizumab. Just before the war against Stalin in June, the RAF dropped the first retaliation bombardment over Hamburg after the Blitz. So Hitler resided in a new headquarters in East Prussia starting June 23rd, built into a mountain in Restenburg to keep him safe for air attacks. The bunker complex was called the Wolf's Lair. But before that, we still need to introduce Benito Mussolini and the offensive that linked the summers of 1940 and 1941, the Blitz. See you on the next one, guys. Peace.